The holy grail for someone like me as a practicing cancer doctor is to be able to better select patients who will benefit most from treatment. At the moment, we're using best guess, empirical combinations, predictive markers allow us to use the science to choose the ideal drugs to which individual patients would be sensitive.
Digital pathology is heading into a new era of artificial intelligence. The Institute for Cancer Genetics and Informatics has developed a new predictive marker for colorectal cancer patients based on deep learning methods.
One of the problems I have with chemotherapy is that we have to treat many, many patients to benefit a few, but many patients experience really dangerous side effects. So if I had a means of better identifying patients that would truly benefit from chemotherapy anti-cancer treatments, we would reduce the pain and burden of suffering on individual patients and reduce costs to the healthcare system.
The DoMore V1 CRC marker was developed by training and tuning machine learning algorithms using the scan slides of patients with a distinctly good or poor disease outcome. The data consisted of four cohorts of colorectal cancer patients, grouped according to their outcome: distinctly good outcome, distinctly poor outcome, and non-distinct outcome. The respective tumor tissue blocks were prepared as H and E stain slides and digitally scanned. More than 12 million image tiles were used to train a total of 10 convolutional neural networks. Patients with a non-distinct outcome were used to determine a prognostic marker that integrated these 10 networks.
Detta är definitivt är innovativt. Här brukar man kunstig intelligens och så är det applicerat på ett väldigt centralt kliniskt område, alltså prognostisering av en vanlig stor kreftgruppe, alltså tykk endetarmskreft. Och det vi ser är att prognostisering är lyftet på ett högre nivå, vi bättre klarer å bestemme hvilke pasienter som skal ha og hvilke pasienter som ikke skal ha behandling.
The marker has been extensively tested and validated in large independent patient populations using slides sourced from different laboratories with variant standards of preparation. It yields consistent results and outperforms established molecular and morphological prognostic markers. To date, it stands as the best marker for classifying patients with stage 2 and 3 colorectal cancer and refining selection of adjuvant treatment. In 2020, the results were published in The Lancet.
Det betyder att våra kollegor vill acceptera metoden när den är publicerad där, och det betyder självklart väldigt mycket för genomslagsevnen som metoden kan få i kliniken, och det är det som är det viktiga att nå fram till patienterna med denna nya metoden.
While potential gains for the patient are great, implementing the method into a clinical setting is simple and can be achieved at low cost. No lab work is required. The histotyping application first annotates the tumor area, which is then partitioned into multiple non-overlapping image regions, called tiles. The mean is calculated for the respective values of each tile and yields the probability for poor prognosis. At this magnification, there is an ensemble of 5 trained models, producing 5 different predictions of poor prognosis. 5 more trained models at higher magnification produce 5 more different predictions of poor prognosis. The combination of these ensemble predictions determines the final ensemble prediction. A report is then generated providing all the details of the final prediction. After a request has been submitted, a patient prediction from slide can be delivered within a minute.
Artificial intelligence is still very much in its early days. There's a lot of claims that will take over and we'll go out of a job. And so that sort of scares some pathologists, and others just say it's irrelevant. But for the meantime, I think it's here. We've got it now. It's developing very rapidly. And there's a lot of very positive aspects come with it.
We have started a spin-off company called DoMore Diagnostics, who will bring this technology to patients worldwide. They are now launching a diagnostic service together with Unilabs.